Today I'm going to show you how to edit a PDF through DotLoop. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to log into your mykw.kw.com account. We are looking specifically for the My Transactions section of eEdge. If for any reason it says below My Transactions that it is coming soon, then you can log out of KW and you can go to DotLoop.com directly and log in there. Through your eEdge control panel, we're going to click on the plus sign next to My Transactions. We're going to go to the second option, Transaction Home. From here, you're going to select the loop that you need to edit. Once you're within the loop, you're going to click on this Add Document button next to the folder you need to add the document to. You can either select Add from My Computer, or you can take the PDF from your computer and drag it and drop it into this section. For now, we're going to click on Computer, and then we're going to find the document that we need. Only PDF documents can be added to a loop, so we're going to select the PDF that we need. Once the PDF has been added, we're simply going to click on the name of the document, which will take us into the document. Along the top, we have an option to add signature, to add a text box, and if we click on more, we can also add in initials. This is where we can select add initials. We can take the initial box and drag it wherever we need it. We can select where we need the initials, and then if we hover over that initial box, on the bottom right hand of that box, there's this little red triangle. If we click on the red triangle, this is where we can click on it and drag it and make this area bigger. The same thing can be done if we add in a text box. We can select where we need a text box. The same thing, if we hover over it, we're going to see the little red triangle in the bottom right. And then we can add in as big of a text box as we need. From there, we can simply start typing in our text. Once we have everything written in, we can then highlight it. And along the top, we have the option now to make that a larger font. When we're all done, we have everything where we need it, we can simply save the document, and now it's ready to be shared. And that's it. That's how you edit a PDF.